You know, I sit in Justice and Legal Affairs Committee. When I hear the Deputy Chief Justice, in whose vetting I was an active player, and whose performance I've known is being arraigned in court, I was interested to go to court and ask, why arrest a DCJ? And this is why I'm telling you, if we are to succeed, Hussein, why should you call a state officer, whether it is Henry Rotich or the DCJ? Why should you order them to be arrested in the way I saw Kamau Thuge being arrested in the office? Why don't you tell them, report to court on such a day to take plea? Look at how long it takes then for us to try these cases. Do I tell you something? In the United Kingdom, first corruption cases are tried in the High Court, not magistrates' courts. And immediately you take plea, it is back to back. That judicial officer does not handle any file until it is done. Look at the amount we were, imposing on cash bail. Not just against this gentleman we took to court today, but against all these cases. We were looking at the case of Governor Kidero the other day. Is taken to court together with several junior officers, people who earn barely 20,000. But the judicial officer says, all of you, in a charge of 58 million, you pay 8 million in cash bail. You know, essentially, you've purported to give a constitutional right, but have taken it away. In England and across Europe and the United States, what happens is that by the time we are charging you with an offense of corruption, the issues of asset recovery are done. You are therefore free to go. In fact, the issue of bail, we don't delay taking, the amount of time I see courts taking every day. Bail is not argued. You go, it is an automatic right, you are under surveillance. Okay. So long as you can guarantee your attendance, you'll be there. Now look, when with the restrictions we have around our bank and our economic situation, you are told, pay 15 million. Why don't you, for a state officer, just tell them, sign this free bond, give us your travel documents, you'll be there. I mean, where is Henry Rotich? Where are these people we are taking so much money as if we are, proceeding on recovery going to? That is why I'm saying we still have a lot to
do. Some would see this as acting as a deterrent so that people
But they are innocent to sin until proven guilty. These guys are innocent. These people are families. These people are friends. These people still have their dignity. In very many, of these cases, you've seen people who have been accused getting acquitted. What we are saying is that in as much as we are fighting corruption, and our goodwill is there for it, whether political or from the public, let us be fair to the people being taken through those processes.
Okay.
You want Kaluma to report to the police. I mean, call me. This is, the CS Treasury. Why would you detain him when Article 49 says immediately you are arrested, you have a right to bail? I mean, what do you gain? Then you'll find situations where even food they can't get, even water, it has to be, some activism. It is unnecessary. Subject
the only problem, I mean, you're fair enough with what you're saying.
Listen, Hussein, but there's something that Kaluma is saying which is very important.
I understand you're about to do it. Just one moment. I'm saying, what do you tell then to Kenyans who sometimes feel politicians should just keep off completely? Not say, like what you're saying could be, some could agree with it, and Honorable Chudet is saying what you're saying is very important.
Yes.
And some would agree with you. Mm-hmm. But there are those who feel politicians would only comment on such matters when it affects them.
Hussein, let me answer you.
What would you tell them?
Those are creations of the media. Those Kenyans you are saying are saying we should not speak are the Kenyans who elect us every time. In fact, we are serving our second term, both of us. And we keep saying these things. My position, and I won't, if Kenyans have a problem. There is a narrative which the media is also singing between us and the people who love the way we represent them and keep electing us, which is not necessary. You want, Kaluma to be subject to the law. Let me tell Kenyans outside there that we chose deliberately to review our previous constitution in which people would be detained without trial. And we said in the Bill of Rights that if you are suspected of having committed an offense, you will be subjected to legal process. This thing of harassing people are not necessary. Tell Kaluma, if he's the person involved, to report to such a police station. Let the police give me my bail. In fact, let me sign a free bond and tell me the court to appear to. You remove those embarrassments and those things you're going to people at dawn. I mean, let me ask you, if the DPP told CS Rotich, and Kamau Thugge report to this court, do you think they would have not reported? Okay. So now, no, when junior Kaluma officers are picking people like they are small people somewhere, yet you know they will be committed to the legal process.
Like small people, what do you mean?
I mean, you saw what happened when Kamau Thugge was being picked.
It's not issue. It's not an issue
abroad,
about small.
I'm telling you, abroad in the UK.
I mean, when you say it's a small people, what do you mean? Like small people? People should be picked differently.
There is, yes, certainly.
Because of their.
Let me tell you something, Hussein. Let me tell you. That stature is regarded.
That's fine.
If you are in the military, for instance, let me tell you. If you are in the military, for instance, if you are to be arrested, it's a person above your rank.
That's the military.
A major cannot be arrested by a small person.
That's fine. That's the military.
How do you, send a police constable to go and arrest a CS being guarded by senior police officers? You get fracas.
Why?
Tell the CS, Hussein, tell the CS to report to a police station or to court.
First of all,
this drama is not useful.
I will not speak for police or whoever. You know, but Honorable Kaluma, I mean, what do you mean a constable cannot arrest a cabinet
shouldn't.
Secretary? Why shouldn't.
Shouldn't.
Why should there be problems about.
The idea.
Why should there be a difference in
I'm answering you. The idea is to secure that a person attends a legal process, whether at police station or court. I'm not talking about the person. I'm saying even the idea that you arrest a state officer is something that is embarrassing no reason.
Which is supposed to be a deterrent.
Tell the state officer to report to court or to the police station, and I assure you they will.
What about the
Mwananchi?
Yeah. What about the Mwananchi who's just done something wrong?
Should do you know why they do it that way, Hussein?
They should be arrested.
In fact, the law does not require that you handcuff people. The law doesn't. Unless a person is resisting arrest, you have no reason even to put handcuff.
So you're
tell
saying,
Hussein, I mean, where would you go, for instance, today? You committed a crime, and we told you to go to Kilimani. Where would you go?
Okay, Honorable.
I mean, check the circumstances of people and tell them to subject themselves to the law.
Everybody is equal above the law. That is the point.
Yes, there is equality before the law, but we also enforce the law to secure obedience to the law.
In ancient Rome, there's a form of punishment called punishing by public naming, where they take you before the public and you're ashamed of what the actions that you have done, and that is considered to be enough punishment. I think DPP and DCI, having realized that because of how they partake of their duties, that it is so difficult to secure a conviction, have resorted to this kind of punitive actions against suspects who they are not able to declare guilty at the end of the process. That is why we had this issue of Kamata Friday. You know, when people began questioning and say, the constitution went to the level and detail of saying, please do not keep suspects more than 24 hours unless it is impossible, because it was known.
Okay.
You know, Hussein, you should also give us some form of understanding to the kind of things that you are saying. We're surely not mad people.
Mm-hmm.
At the age of 33, serving my second term in the Senate,
I'm
not a fool. So when you hear me raise certain particular issues about how a particular exercise is being conducted, it tells you that there are certain issues.